Astu Dufall jumping up against Elizabeth Williams, and we are underway here from Wintrust Elite Best in terms of just a scoring duo. That's Dufall with the first look. She gets the rebound, and that's a two-point shot for Diamond Mashiel. She needed to take just a little bit of a step back for that to be a three.
5 and 6, 4 down low.
Mashiel that time with a 15-footer into the hands of Tiffany Hayes, who's playing in her third game of the season, and she takes it the distance to tie it at 2. She's hit a couple already this season. 2 of 8 now for the season, and nothing but net for Courtney Williams. Hesitation move here from Hayes, takes the contact and the bucket. She looked at the official. She wanted the foul to go along with it. 4 turnovers for Atlanta to match the 4 buckets. That's not exactly the ratio that you want to start. The pull-up is good for Copper. Throughout the years, you know, the WNBA bubble as an example last year, an even greater way to unite the players and the coaches for that platform, trying to create that positive change for our society. And they always have been. It didn't just start last summer. There's a 3, and coming off the bench.
Much space for McDonald to let it fly.
Yeah, it has been rookie against rookie there in that matchup. And the pump fake and 2, and some nice momentum here for the Atlanta Dream. Create a lot of production in the last couple of minutes, last couple of possessions for Atlanta. It's been the opposite. This bench has given them a spark, and here's McDonald again. She's got another bucket and a quick 5-point opportunity here for the Dream. 7 seconds on the shot clock. McDonald, count it. Oh, the rookie, a quick 7 points off the bench.
Like you said, true Diana Taurasi fashion, play 2 games with that type of injury.
Here's Sloot coming out of that timeout, and they go 22's way for the 2 and cutting the lead here to 8. And have gotten some spark off the bench to build that lead against the home team, the Chicago Sky. Double team coming, Courtney Williams. Here's Watts with the kick out to Sloot for 3, and she drills it. Actually, her first miss here tonight. She's now 3 of 4 off the bench. Good feed. Dufall picks up another assist for Courtney Vandersloot, and she gets herself a bucket. A little bit of a delay coming over from Australia, using as the backup point guard and the 8th overall pick this year. The putback is good for Elizabeth Williams, who stays in this game playing with the 2 personals. Chicago working it around. That one was swatted by Kennedy Carter. Still stays in the possession here for Chicago as DeShields pulls and fires.
That ball has been like a hot potato the last couple of possessions for both teams. No one quite holding possession.
Crystal Bradford sizes it up for 3. Kennedy Williams and Kennedy Carter combining for 1 of 7 shooting and just 3 points. Carter still looking for her first points here tonight.
And credit Chicago's defense as.
Here is Williams. Back out to Bradford. Good ball movement here for the Dream, and it leads to that, a Tiffany Hayes 3. Azaree Stevens has checked in. Still on a little bit of a minute restriction dealing with that foot injury, but Diamond DeShields finds her beautifully.
The ability to get down the floor in just a couple of steps.
Even Kalia Copper has her limitations, even as athletic as she is. The pull-up is pure and smooth for Courtney Williams. It's a whole lot of contact made as well, which she was trying to probably argue her point on that play. Here's Courtney Williams for 3, and she's heating up a little bit.
Today, like you mentioned, Atlanta has come in red hot.
McDonald missed the first time. She misses again on this possession, but Billings won on the putback. In terms of points scored in Chicago Sky franchise history, and wouldn't that be interesting to watch here throughout this season as that kind of evolves between the two? Well, Chicago coming out of the halftime getting the first bucket. It's Williams who works it around to Hayes that time. Not sure if she called glass. It'll go down in the scorebook all the same for the 3-point shot.
My goodness. Talk about calling your shot, knocking it, using the glass. Still counts for 3 points, like you said.
The 5th 3-point make right now for Atlanta as they try to off and running. Again, Kennedy Carter, that's her first points and her first bucket tonight. Team starting lineups to begin the second half as both of these teams began the game with. Hebert with the kick out here to Copper, who goes baseline, and they'll count it.
Someone needs to tell somebody who works in facilities that probably then.
And taking the contact, a huge and 1. Elizabeth Williams back the other way and drawing the foul on Dufall.
James Wade has found a great job to fit her into his system. Just a nice complimentary piece for this guy.
And Carter just forcing the issue and drawing the foul on Vandersloot. It's Bradford with a move. I mean, she looks like she's played in the WNBA since 2015.
Bradford at 6 foot has a height advantage over a 5'7", 5'8", Shyla Heal, and taking advantage of just that.
And it's Azaray's shell drills, kind of mental reps, watching some film. And that's the offense that they have to get through sometimes with practices and shoot-arounds right now. And there's the take for Stephanie Watts. Her five new players have joined this team, either because of the free agency drafting. Someone like Crystal Bradford joined the team in a training camp contract. And Chicago needs more of that from the corner, like Kalia Copper just drilled it. Zero fast break points here for Chicago. This dream defense has gotten back, and Diamond DeShields doing what she does best and creating her own shot. Courtney Williams trying to go baseline. She'll kick it out, and this is the ball movement that we've seen by the Atlanta Dream here tonight, and the finish by Williams.
Every single possession that's allowed them to get even more open player in the basket.
11 assists now in this game. Azaray Stevens from deep, from the top of the key for three.
Chicago heating up that last time out. Something was said, but now starting to get a little bit some offensive continuity going.
And for a team that struggled hitting the three-point shot.
The silent 9 points in between that time, and just making such a big impact with her size, length, offensively and defensively, as Copper knocks down a much-needed bucket for Chicago.
The 15-footer here for Copper, and she's got 14 points here in this game. Azaray Stevens has played about 17 minutes in this game. That's a season high for her. She's been dealing with a foot injury. Bradford is so impressive. Other than Watts, the regular starters in for Chicago. Duvall taking the pass, turning and firing and hitting.
Copper doing a nice job reading the defense. Atlanta brought two players up to try to trap. Copper threads the needle to Duvall going to the basket.
11 points now for Duvall, and Williams hits the three. Only in practice and shoot around, but here in the games. Vandersloot with the cross court pass to DeShields. There's some flow to that possession. Here's Kennedy Carter, who's had a very, very quiet night here tonight. Courtney Williams stroking it from deep. They trail just by 9 points here to Atlanta. 11 seconds left on the shot clock from the out of bounds, and the baseline is good here for Hayes. Carter with 5 points, all coming in the second half. She was scoreless in the first half, in the first minute of this second half. And Sloop steps into it. She's got 7 points tonight.
Maintains composure late in shot clock situations.
That's a friendly bounce there for Hawkins for two. Shooting. So she'll take any kind of friendly bounce that she can get from the rim. 7 seconds. Shovel pass there to Stevens for two. And playing a season high about 19 minutes in this game. Williams with the good hard take in for two.
Sort of offensive momentum they could possibly generate.
Shooting just 27% from three as a team in Chicago. And three of their 4 3-point makes coming in the third quarter.
Any team that can get the type of bench production that Atlanta was able to do in the first half, 19 bench points in the first half alone, that's only good for the longevity of a season. Also good for Chicago regarding their longevity this season.
A 20-point game for Kalia Copper. She's at 21. Under 2 minutes to play, 10-point advantage for Atlanta. And Vandersloot with that hesitation and body control against Elizabeth Williams. And the final few seconds here of this game, and Chicago working it around. Courtney Vandersloot for three. She hits it from the corner. And over 3,000 points. And atop the Chicago Sky scoring advantage in franchise history.